this idea of, quote, regulation has gotten a bad word in the political lexicon of the United States. And I'm not a big fan of overregulation, but I am a big fan of the trade-off, that in this country we encourage the private sector to invest, and we incent it through the tax code, we incent it through how we educate people, we incent it through sort of a philosophy that's embedded in the Constitution about private property. But one of the trade-offs of that is responsibility. Responsibility to the community, responsibility to the nation.
Shonda, you want to say anything about the community reinvestment?
Yeah, I was just going to say, you know, I think clearly all of the things you guys are saying is spot on, but I also think that the responsibility piece is something that we as an industry and at Chase have to have, regardless of where the regulatory and where the direction will go or continue to go. And what I mean by that is these are communities in which we live and work, where our families live. And when we talk about CRA or continuing to stay focused and making sure minorities can achieve home ownership, I think it has to be in the fabric of your organization. And at Chase, we have a department that's just part of who we are and do business to make sure that regardless of what the CRA requirements are, regardless of what the industry or regulators may say, we just have to fundamentally believe that it's the right thing to do, that it, when done well, everyone wins, the consumer, the community, and the bank. And we have to make sure that within that fiber, that we are in communities of all income levels, from the bank or that we're lending in all markets, that we have people that reflect the market, that we're doing it well, that we provide subsidy dollars to help low to moderate income borrowers close that gap, and that we participate in soft seconds and other programs to make sure that housing is more affordable. So I think CRA will continue to be a focus. It's something that we're proud of and are committed to doing, but I think beyond that, it just has to be core responsibility that the company believes in. And if you believe in it, it will sustain whatever the environment brings.
Nick, you wanted to...
You know, it's ironic, Mark. When I first joined the Joint Center over a decade ago now, the first study we did was on the efficacy of CRA from the period, really that period of the 1990s. And I think we demonstrated conclusively that it does make a difference at the margin. I think what happened over time is the financial services industry evolved. Mortgage finance changed, and there was a race between the market and the government. The market won, and the government was sort of left behind, which goes to my earlier point. I think the criticism is there wasn't enough CRA, not that there was too much CRA. It just fell behind.
Sure. Barney?
Just a very quick observation. The rationale for CRA originally was that federally insured depository institutions had a public benefit in that they had the government insuring, and hence there was a reason to have a publicly defined responsibility to serve the community. One could argue that right now, as the Fed's window of credit has expanded to investment banks, perhaps to insurance companies, to others, that same exact rationale, that if you're getting governmentally insured liabilities or direct governmental investment, that there should be a corresponding public responsibility. And so I think there is a time in history right now to make the case for expanding CRA that we haven't had in recent times.
Sure.
I totally agree with that. Just let me. We are at an absolutely great, in that sense, moment in history because everybody realizes the system is completely broken and we need to change it. And CRA is a really interesting proposition. When you really look at it, the teeth that a regulator has to make sure that banks do the right thing under CRA are really not all that sharp, but banks do pay attention to it, and their boards of directors spend a lot of time talking about CRA. It's a very important thing. But I think one thing that we really have a responsibility to do is to keep harping on the notion that CRA is good for everybody. Because when you make investments in communities, in low-income communities, and people get jobs and businesses get funded, that's good for everybody. And the banks make more business. And you have to remember, these are fiduciary institutions. They're supposed to make money. They can't just go and lend money to people when they don't think it's going to be paid back. Sure. So you have a lot of different forces there.